It's like 83 here. I mean, seriously. Okay. Up to now, my creative work has been biographical, but it was mainly visual. My web pages were collages of different visual images, and my YouTube videos have been focused primarily on the composition, the visual composition, and the writing really only supported the images that I was using. But this year I'd like to reverse that. I have to read from my script, I'm sorry. I never do anything without a script. I never did. Ow, now I'm getting a cramp. So I'm self-publishing a set of autobiographical essays on my website in which Photoshop is not the star. This time the focus is on the words. The title of the project is Snapshots. The first installment is a kind of prologue, a set of three poems I wrote in 2007 for an anthology of gay men writing about their mothers. The anthology was never published in the end, unfortunately. I think it would have been a good project, but... Nothing I do creatively is a source of income for me. But I still take it seriously because it is what I enjoy doing, and it's what has the most meaning. The good thing about the time period in which I'm living is that I can still make my little contribution to American literature, as long as I pay my monthly hosting fee. I'm very much of an American, and my favorite artists and writers are all Americans. I've often felt almost lectured at for not being perky, for making sad videos, or for being overly pessimistic in my writing. But the story of my life and my attitude was never the point. The point was taking whatever I felt strongly and creating visual designs or verbal symbolism out of it, of doing something well or creating something beautiful. It's almost impossible to undertake these kinds of projects and avoid the implied self-importance. Sometimes in my work I felt like I was composing a time capsule, or, as I always like to say, singing into the toilet. That's the way it feels. Anyway. Really, I guess I just want the small handful of people who have followed me in the past couple of years to know where I'm headed, to know what I'm working on, and to know where to find me. I'd like to read the second poem in the prologue, which could be one of my favorite things. Borrowing from Robert Frost for a moment here. Something there is that doesn't love a boy, beyond a certain age. Throttled by glasses, his narrow face maniacal for attention, or made glum by the effacement of the group. Ruins every Christmas shot. He's not quite like his brothers, their wives and babies, and the camera moves on through the party to another spot. The turkey's almost done. A guiding star has misdirected him here, seated between a high chair and a cloud of smoke. An awkward age, an unlucky slot. So much younger, and yet not quite young enough. A final son, with a different father, dead, unremembered, and hardly the same mother, so transformed by pain, cauterized by cocktails. The softness had gone, evaporated by the heat of rage. A boy remained, fatherless and girly, fragile as a glass ornament that is tucked within the branches, out of sight for its protection. His mother's instamatic lacks a setting that might flatter him. A special boy, a gaping problem, subsumed by a mother's final tour as a woman, even as her grandchildren appeared. A childhood of satisfactions repeatedly deferred, like a thousand Christmas Eves, compacted his hunger, intensifying it. A fire banked with nothing to burn. An auxiliary heat, a radiator in July. His eyes could not contain their wealth, which pranced before the camera like a deer.